So hope you all enjoy the clip.
Absolutely.
Yes.
I mean, we probably need to play music for you guys so you guys can get ginger up. Okay, let's go. So, for a long time, we've had lots of challenges as a country, Nigeria. But the big question has always been that this country has great potential. So the real question is, who are the people that are going to make this potential come to reality? Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Douglas Emeka Oko. I'm a brain surgeon. I'm proudly Nigerian. And I'm passionate about redefining what most people know about Nigeria and taking Nigeria into the future. And what I'm trying to do today is to try and inspire you guys and try and make you guys think along those lines and act along those lines as well. And basically, I'm going to be talking about your role in the new Nigeria. So we have a new dispensation in Nigeria now, a new government headed by President Muhammadu Buhari. Now, a big question that one key thing that comes up time after time is talking about politics. And I hear lots of people, Nigerians, say that they are not interested in politics. They don't like politics. Politics is a dirty game. But the crucial thing here is that when you talk about delivery of services, when you talk about building of infrastructure, hospitals, a good railway system, a good transport system, a good economy, an economy that is buoyant, an economy that delivers jobs to young people, that understands about skills, building skills. Everything is hinged on government and government policies. And to get government, there is politics. Now, I remember a chap saying something very crucial and very key, and that's something that I want all of us to know today. You cannot leave politics to just the politicians. Because you're talking about your life, you're talking about the life of your children, you're talking about the lives of your children's children. For those of us who are based in the UK here, you will agree with me that we all have either cousins, mothers, grandmothers, relations back in Nigeria. Now, we can say that, oh, we are in the UK, those things, they don't concern us in Nigeria. Or we can think, look at the bigger picture and understand that what happens in Nigeria, whether we like it or not, affects us one way or the other. So what is your sociopolitical contribution? What is your contribution towards politics? First, the first thing you should do is that you come to a point where you are interested in politics. And what does being interested in politics mean? It doesn't mean going for office or being directly involved in politics. First of all, the first thing you should know what happens in your country. It's fundamental. Imagine you as a Nigerian and you're talking with somebody maybe from India or from Japan or from any other part of the world, and they ask you a question about what's happening in your country. Oh, we heard this Boko Haram in your country. And you say, oh, well, I don't really know much about that. That doesn't speak well of you. So you have to be interested. Spend some time. Go put Nigerian news on Google. Find out what's happening in Nigeria. Be interested in what's happening in Nigeria. Because like I said, whatever happens in Nigeria affects you. Very, very important. So, I always tell most young Nigerians, especially students, professionals here in the UK, that you are all called. I graduated from a school called the University of Benin. Remember the Oba that they're talking about that was the Boko Haram? Yeah, I graduated from, in fact, I grew up in that area of Nigeria. And I graduated from a school called University of Benin. Now, the motto of University of Benin is knowledge for service. Knowledge for service. Okay? So, most of us have come to the UK, or some of us even grew up in the UK, and most of us are here in university. And what do you go to university to do? Two key things. You learn only to grow, you go there to to gain knowledge and also to gain skill as well. Now, what I'm still telling you is that your knowledge is for service. If you look at Nigeria, has a population of about 170 million, going to 180 million. We've not counted, but I'm sure the population of Nigeria is massive. Now, if you were to look at the number of people who are educated in Nigeria, you have a large number of people who are not educated. Now, if you look at the number of people who are educated in Nigeria, who are probably going to university in Nigeria, and look at someone like you, who is here in a country that I would describe as a developed economy, not a developed country, because if you say the UK, for example, is a developed country, you might be saying that everything in the UK is developed compared to Nigeria. No, but mainly their economy is more developed. So you have been called, you're special for you to actually be in a place like this, in a developed economy where you have infrastructure, where you're in a school teaching aids and stuff like that, that will make you much better compared to your contemporaries back in Nigeria. So you are called. So the next question is, are you going to be chosen? And what does it mean to be chosen? What does it mean when you are blessed to be in this place and you have millions of other people to be where you are? They say that responsibility comes when you get to a particular level in life. When you're given a blessing, it comes with responsibility. So the big question I have to you is that, will you be chosen? Because you're already called. You are a special breed. Yeah, this is frozen. ICT.
Okay, shut up.
I need to know the word.
Nigerian man.
Can somebody help me here, please? So, I guess the big question here is, one of the things I always ask Nigerians when they come over to the UK, when they come for, especially for postgraduate studies, the first thing I ask them is, why are you doing this course? MSc, engineering, MSc, public health, MSc this, MSc that, PhD this, PhD that. I ask them from the medical school, why are you studying this? And therefore, we have to go back and look at our educational system in Nigeria and basically our social-cultural perspective of what education is all about. And one of the things I find out is that if you look at Nigeria, Nigeria is a place where, because of where we are coming from, i.e. the oil boom in the 70s, where everything that we now do is now centered on oil, on crude oil, where we run a rent economy. I'll describe what a rent economy is. A rent economy is free money. Free money. You know, you have crude oil in most parts of the Niger Delta. We did not put it there. We did not physically put the oil there in the ground. And even the exploration of the oil for many years have been done by foreign nationals. It's just recently that you now have indigenous people venturing into the oil and gas industry. So it's free money, and the money is controlled by the federal government. So everybody struggles for that money. And in that kind of system, what happens is that you have a situation where people do not innovate, they do not create, and everybody wants to get its own share of that free money. So what happens? You find a situation where people do everything to get their own share. And one of the ways they do it is to try and get a certificate. So you have, and that's why you have very big names in Nigeria. I mean, master's holder, I mean, PhD, I mean, professor. And all this is, you have people who don't add any value to the system. So what you now have in Nigeria is people will not have certificates in Nigeria. Now, but if you look at Nigeria in real terms, you have a situation where you have lots of Indians, Chinese people coming to the ground to try and do lots of skilled work. So even though you have a massive population, that's big potential. potential for greatness and for development. You have a massive skills gap. So what I'm showing to you, young Nigerians, is that, yes, you've come here to have an academic degree, or to have a degree. Now, what you should start thinking is, number one, you are a problem solver, and you are a Nigerian, and Nigeria has myriad of problems. Where are you going to key in? Are you going to come in here and come and have a certificate?